Good morning, Stephen Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Tuesday, July 19th, 2011. In this presentation, we'll cover both sides of the border. Last time we talked was on Friday. Friday's trading activity was actually an inside day for most of the major indexes, so not a lot of guidance from Friday. Monday was a down day. What we're seeing in the pre-market this morning in the futures looks like it's going to erase most of Monday's losses, so that takes us back to Friday. So no guidance there so far. We'll have to see if we get fall through to the upside, but we are going to see a positive open Tuesday morning at 9:30. Let's start off this morning taking a look at some stocks in the news, starting with News Corp. And looking at the stock chart itself, there's really no way that you could equate what's going on in the public and the media, the PR battle that's going on right now, with the stock itself. Certainly investors do not feel as bad about this company as the man on the street and anybody in the media does at the moment. Sure, it was up at the top of the panic zones, had an early warning signal, started to sell off. All this is normal. We're down at the bottom of the panic zones. We haven't cut through the bottom of the panic zones. There's been no acceleration to the downside. We're back at support, back at prices that we saw in the wintertime. This stock chart looks a lot better than a lot of other companies, and those other companies are not the lead story on every news program around the world. So this stock is holding up incredibly well. Obviously, investors still feel very good about the company. If you look at the bottom left-hand corner, you'll see an open gap just above 1250, and that could be a potential target for this stock if it continues to move lower from here. But obviously, investors, there's a big disconnect between how the public feels about this company and how investors feel about this company at the present time. Take a look at IBM. It reported after hours and apparently impressed people. It was up after hours. And so that's not out of line with how investors felt about it yesterday. We had an early warning signal go off a couple of days ago. No fall through to the downside. And so we're expecting higher prices here today and no chance of a sell signal for IBM on Tuesday. Looking at Bank of America, it traded below $10 yesterday. It reported its biggest loss in history, and I would imagine that we are seeing it up in the pre-market this morning, and that's probably some short covering. We need a close, a daily close above 10.55 to give us a buy signal on Tuesday. Goldman Sachs also reported it's down in the pre-market. We need to close above 133.12 to change that on Tuesday. Apple Computer reports after hours today, and investors are very excited about this stock ahead of those earnings. I don't know if it's a buy the rumor, sell the news. We'll have to see about that later. But 350.67, a daily close below that, would give us a sell signal, and I certainly don't expect to see that on Tuesday. Let's take a quick look at the major indexes, starting with the VIX. We still have the VIX on a buy signal, and that, of course, is negative for stock prices. A daily close below 1790 would change that on Tuesday. The TSX has been trading in the channel the last couple of days, a couple of inside days. We need a daily close above 13,558.20 to give us a buy signal on Tuesday. Most of that support, of course, is coming from the materials and the gold sector. Nothing going on with energy right now. Financial services continues to move lower, and that is putting downward pressure on the TSX. Gold stocks continuing to move higher. Material stocks continuing to move higher. That is very positive for the TSX. Looking at the S&P 500, we need to close above 1329.65 on Tuesday to give us a buy signal. We bounced off 1296 yesterday. That was our target, if you remember from last week. And so we've reversed off that target, and now we need to get back over 1312.50. Taking a look at the NASDAQ 100, we need to close above 2366.36 on Tuesday. Looking at U.S. bank stocks, they continue to move lower on Monday. A close above 136.51 would change that. We saw continued weakness in the chip sector on Monday. A close above 404.89 would change that. Gold stocks continue to move higher. A close below 206.99 would give us a sell signal on Tuesday. No change for the 30-year bond. No change for the euro. Still on a sell signal. U.S. dollar still on a buy signal. Canadian dollar still on a buy signal. No major changes for commodity futures over the last couple of days. Copper still on a buy signal. Gold continues to move higher. Still no early warning signal here. Next target to the upside is 1625. Then 1750 is our next major target above that. But we've reached the range, the top of the range on our daily charts, and we would expect it to stop here. But if it does not, then this range will expand over the next couple of days if we break out above 1625. Looking to the downside, we need to close way down below 1546.39. Silver's starting to move up nicely. You know, on a percentage term, silver's outdoing gold right now, which is great. And we love those silver stocks. We need to close below 36.19 on Tuesday to change things. Next target to the upside for silver, if we can break out above yesterday's high, is up at 43.75. Looking at crude oil, no change there. No change for gasoline and no change for natural gas. We're still on a buy signal. Next up, let's take a look at Tuesday's roadmap, starting with the S&P 500 Cash Index. We need to close above, an hourly close above 1307.82 to give us an intraday buy signal on Tuesday. And we're certainly going to be at those levels at the open, so we'll have to see how we do at 10:30 this morning. On the downside, if we take out yesterday's low, we're looking for a move down to 1381.25. On the upside, our first area of resistance is 1312.50, and that comes in line with the bottom of the hourly flypaper channel, which takes us up just under 1320. So we're looking for a band of resistance in that area. Looking at the TSX, we've basically been treading water for the last few days. You know, if you look at the daily chart, you'll see we're in the channel. So we're really looking for a breakout above the recent high or the recent low to tell us which way we're heading next. But otherwise, we're just treading water here. A big tug of war money leaving financials and heading into materials and gold stocks. Looking at the hourly flypaper channel for the TSX, you can see we're just trading around the hourly flypaper, have not really been able to break away to the upside or the downside. An hourly close above 13,274 would give us an intraday buy signal on Tuesday. With what we're seeing in the futures market this morning, it looks like we're going to be able to close above the upper channel line at 10:30 this morning, which would generate a new intraday buy signal for the TSX. Okay, that's all for Tuesday morning, folks. Have a great day. We'll talk to you again on Wednesday morning.